I think it's immensely important. I mean, I think that societies like ours, the APAO, as well as the American Academy, really seeks to empower, educate, as well as engage YOs, or young ophthalmologists, all around the world.
And it's so important to have folks like Marcus and even myself to mentor, you know, show them the opportunities they have because they're really endless. And to see them at this early in their stage and see what they can do, it's really enlightening. And it's fun for us. We really enjoy the opportunity to enlighten them.
Yeah, I would encourage it. I think ophthalmology is an amazing subspecialty within clinical medicine. We are moving at a frightening pace. Technology, AI, digital tech is part and parcel of our practice now. And I think that it's really exciting times. I think in the last 5 years alone, you know, ophthalmology has really advanced. So I would say to young people, take up ophthalmology.
And the opportunities they have are endless. Our populations, virtually in every country, are getting older. And one of the things they need is vision care. And so they can really choose different parts of ophthalmology, whatever they find most enlightening. And they can also almost find any place that they prefer, they might want to settle. So it gives you a lot of opportunities that actually other areas of medicine don't have. And as Marcus pointed out, I mean, what's so fun about ophthalmology is you can change somebody's lives by cataract surgery or cornea surgery, as Marcus does. And it's so rewarding. It's just so rewarding. You just every day is rewarding.
I think Dan hit the nail on the head. I think that the problem is that the burden, the global burden of visual impairment is rising. And actually, we don't have enough resources. We try, but there's not enough resources, manpower, to deal with this. And essentially, the world needs ophthalmology. And what we hope that we can harness is technology to help us advance, provide access, assist clinicians, to make better eye care, to provide better eye care for our patients. So, yeah.
And there's no question that technology is going to allow us to do that. Some of the most well-attended lectures today were on AI, and that may allow us, as Marcus said, to determine which people need us the most and which people might be able to be handled by perhaps a technician or another provider. So we really feel that AI, I mean, it's getting really close to where we'll be able to find which people need our help the most and which ones are most in need of the surgical techniques that Marcus does or cataract surgery that I do.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I think it is as well. In fact, ophthalmology was in the US was the lowest utilizer of telemedicine.
Really?
The lowest compared to, say, psychiatry. And I think, yeah, I think we're going to find more uses for that. And I think it did jumpstart us. I absolutely agree. But we still have a ways to go, I think, in that regard, because we're such a face-to-face profession. But I agree. I think and between that and AI, I think we're going to see a lot of changes in the next few years. Well, let me say I can't thank the people from Malaysia enough. The Malaysia organizers, Dr. Fong and some of the rest, have been unbelievably warm and friendly, and the hospitality has been overwhelming for those of us from the American side, even though we traveled myself 26 hours to get here, and it was worth every hour. So I would come back again, and I look forward to coming back again when I have to spend less time here and more time out in KL and the surrounding areas. So thank you, the Malaysia Ophthalmology Society and the AUPO for inviting the American Academy of Ophthalmology to co-sponsor.
Well, I mean, coming from Asia, APAO has been fantastic because this is actually the first time we're meeting in person, face to face, since the pandemic. So to see friends again, to see colleagues again, to learn together, to reconnect, has been absolutely fantastic. And I agree with Dan, Malaysian Society of Ophthalmology has been fantastic hosts. And I think being Singapore and being close to Malaysia, you know, we are definitely very, very proud.